Good morning, students. Yesterday we discussed how to find integration and how the formulas are obtained. In this class we discuss the methods of finding integration. In differentiation there are several methods to find the derivatives. Differentiation by parametric form, implicit differentiation, logarithmic differentiation. In this way there are different methods to find the derivative of the given function. Here also there are different methods to find integration. Write the methods. Methods of integration. Now we discuss the methods to find integration. There are three different methods to find integration. There are three different methods to find integration. First method, integration by substitution. Integration by substitution. Next, integration by partial fractions. Third, integration by parts. Now I am explaining briefly how these methods are applied to find the integration. Integration by substitution. By substituting the function in the given problem with some variable, we can find the integration. That is called integration by substitution method. Next, integration by partial fractions. By decomposing the given function into sum of partial fractions, already we discussed how to resolve the given function into partial fractions. By decomposing into partial fractions, we find integration. Next, integration by parts. Here, we find the integration by using partwise. That means how to find integration by using product rule, that we discuss in this method, integration by parts. These are the three different methods to find integration of the given function. First we discuss the first method, integration by substitution. Integration by substitution. In this, we discuss some important results. First one, if integral f of x dx is equal to some function g of x plus c, then integral of f of ax plus b into dx, that is equal to 1 by a into g of ax plus b plus c. If integral of the given function f of x is some another function g of x, then integral of f of ax plus b, here in place of x there is ax plus b, integral f of ax plus b dx is equal to 1 by a into g of ax plus b plus c. Now we prove this result. Given integral f of x dx is equal to g of x plus c, let it be equation 1. Here we want to find integral of f of ax plus b dx. Here in place of x we have ax plus b. Let that ax plus b is equal to some t. Ax plus b is equal to t. Now differentiating both sides with respect to x, what we get? A into d by dx of x, that is 1, plus derivative of any constant 0 is equal to d by dx of t. Now on cross multiplying what we get? A into dx is equal to dt. A into dx is equal to dt. Now from this, what is dx? Dt by a. Therefore integral of f of ax plus b dx is equal to integral of f of ax plus b is t, from our assumption f of t into dx. What is dx? Dt by a. Dx is dt by a. Now this is equal to 1 by a into, 1 by a is constant, integral f of t dt. Integral f of x dx is what? G of x plus c. Then integral f of t dt, that is g of t plus c, in you put x is equal to t in equation 1, so we get g of t plus c from equation 1. This is equal to 1 by a into, but t is what? Ax plus b. G of ax plus b plus c, that is RHS. So here we observe that if integral of f of x is g of x plus c, then integral of f of ax plus b is 1 by a into g of ax plus b. Here a is the derivative of this function ax plus b. Now you see one or two examples. Integral of cos 2x dx. It is in the form of integral cos x into dx. You observe this example. It is in the form of integral cos x dx. We know the formula, integral cos x is sin x plus c. So integral cos 2x is sine 2x plus c. But what is the derivative of this 2x? 2 divided with 2. Here integral cos x dx is equal to sin x plus c. Oh, we know that formula well. But in place of x there is 2x. So integral cos 2x is sin 2x by derivative of this 2x 2. Here you see this result. If integral f of x is g of x plus c, then integral ax plus b is g of ax plus b by a. By using that same result, if integral cos x is sin x, then integral cos 2x is sin 2x by 2. There is a difference between integral and derivative. While finding derivative, you know d by dx of cos x is equal to minus sin x. D by dx of cos x is equal to minus sin x. D by dx of cos 2x, that is equal to minus sin 2x into derivative of this 2x, that is 2. In differentiation, you observe, in differentiation multiply with the derivative. In integration you divide with the derivative. You observe the difference clearly. In differentiation d by dx of cos x is equal to minus sin x. D by dx of cos 2x is minus sin 2x into derivative of 2x. In integration, integral cos x is sin x. Integral cos 2x is sin 2x by derivative of that 2x, that is 2. Similarly, integral cos 3x dx, that is equal to sin 3x by 3. Sin 3x by 3 plus c. That is the difference between derivative and integration. In differentiation you multiply with the derivative. In integration you divide with the derivative. Similarly, integral 1 by 5x dx. We know integral 1 by x is log x. So integral 1 by 5x is log 5x by derivative of 5x, that is 5 plus c. You put modulus for logarithm. This is example 2, this is example 1. In a function, if x is replaced with another function, you write the derivative integration and divide that with derivative. Next, next result. Integral f dash x by f of x dx is equal to log mod f of x plus c. You observe that denominator is the function f of x, numerator is derivative of denominator. F dash x means derivative of f of x. So it is in the form of integral of derivative of denominator by the denominator f of x. See the proof. Let f of x is equal to sum t, differentiating both sides with respect to x, then we get f dash x is equal to dt by dx. Differentiate both sides with respect to x. Derivative of the first derivative of f of x is f dash x is equal to d by dx of t. On cross multiplying, we get f dash x dx is equal to dt. Therefore, integral of f dash x by f of x dx is equal to, now change it in terms of t, f dash x dx, that is dt by f of x. What is f of x? That is t. It is in the form of integral 1 by x into dx. Integral 1 by x dx is log mod x. So integral 1 by t dt is log mod t plus c. That is equal to log of, but what is t from our assumption f of x? Plus c. Therefore, integral f dash x by f of x dx is equal to log of mod f of x plus c. By using this result, we derive some formulas in integration. Next, third one, integral of tan x into dx is equal to log mod secant x plus c. Prove this. See, what is LHS? Integral tan x into dx. Tan x is taken as sin x by cos x. Tan x is written as sin x by cos x. You observe that clearly. You say, what is the derivative of cos x? That is minus sin x. You write numerator as minus of integral minus sin x by cos x into dx. You write sin x as minus of minus sin x. Then it is in the form of integral f dash x by f of x. Clearly, derivative of cos x is minus sin x. Derivative of denominator is the numerator. So it is in this form. If the given integral is in this form, then its integral value is log of mod f of x minus log of mod, what is f of x here? Cos x plus c. Here, if you take f of x is equal to cos x, then f dash x is equal to minus sin x. Numerator is the derivative of denominator. If numerator is derivative of denominator, then its integral value is log of that denominator. Here, denominator is cos x. Now, we write it as log of cos x whole to the power of minus 1 or 1 by cos x. 1 by cos x is secant x. C is log mod secant x plus c. Next, integral of cot x into dx is equal to log mod sin x plus c. what is LHS? Integral cortex into dx. Here cortex is taken as cos x by sin x. You write cortex as cos x by sin x into dx. You observe that if f of x is sin x, then its derivative f dash x is cos x. So numerator is the derivative of denominator. If numerator is derivative of denominator, then its integral value is log of that denominator. Write it as integral of derivative of sin x by sin x. Cos x is taken as derivative of sin x. Now it is in the form of integral f dash x by f of x. Now its integral value is log of f of x. What is this denominator? Sin x. Log of sin x plus c. Always in integration, if numerator is the derivative of denominator, then its integral value is log of that denominator. Next, integral of secant x into dx is equal to log mod secant x plus tan x plus c, or that is equal to log tan of pi by 4 plus x by 2 plus c. Integral secant x dx, that is the given problem. Now we write it as here multiply numerator and denominator with secant x plus tan x. Take this secant x into bracket. Secant x into secant x, secant square x plus secant x into tan x by secant x plus tan x into dx. Now we observe that numerator is the derivative of denominator. What is the denominator? Secant x plus tan x. You see derivative. Derivative of secant x into tan x. Derivative of tan x, that is secant square x. So clearly numerator is the derivative of denominator. If numerator is derivative of denominator, then its integral is log of mod denominator. Integral is log of mod, what is denominator? Secant x plus tan x plus c. In any problem, if numerator is derivative of denominator, then its integral is log of that denominator. Okay, first part is completed. Now we prove the second part. This is equal to log of secant x is written as 1 by cos x, tan x is written as sin x by cos x. on taking LCM, what we get? Cos x. In numerator, we get 1 plus sin x plus log of we write sin x as minus cos 90 plus x. Cos 90 plus x is minus sin x. Minus into minus plus. So we get 1 plus sin x. Cos x is written as sin 90 plus x. Sin 90 plus x, that is cos x. Cos 90 plus x, that is minus sin x. Here minus into minus plus. Okay. That is equal to log of, it is in the form of 1 minus cos A. We know the formula, 1 minus cos A is equal to 2 sin square A by 2 in trigonometry. 1 minus cos A is equal to 2 sin square A by 2. By applying that formula, numerator becomes 2 sin square A by 2, pi by 2 plus x by 2. It becomes pi by 4 plus x by 2. By denominator, denominator is in the form of sin A. In half angle, it is 2 sin A by 2 cos A by 2. What is A? Pi by 2 plus x. From this formula, it becomes 2 into sin A by 2. A by 2 means pi by 4 plus x by 2 to cos pi by 4 plus x by 2 plus c. 2 cancel, sin one time cancel, you get log of mod sin pi by 4 plus x by 2 by cos pi by 4 plus x by 2, that is tan of pi by 4 plus x by 2 plus c. You may apply either this formula or this formula depending upon the nature of the problem. Next, integral cosecant x dx is equal to, next result, log of mod cosecant x minus cot x plus c, or that is equal to log of tan x by 2 plus c. Integral LHS is integral cosecant x into dx. We write this as integral of here multiply numerator and denominator with cosecant x minus cot x. Integral of, take this cosecant x into bracket, cosecant x into cosecant x, cosecant square x minus cosecant x into cot x by cosecant x minus cot x to dx. Observe that numerator is the derivative of denominator. What is denominator? Cosecant x minus cot x. Derivative of this denominator, d by dx of cosecant x minus cosecant x plus cot x, d by dx of cot x minus cosecant square x minus into minus plus, so plus cosecant square x. So clearly numerator is derivative of denominator. If numerator is derivative of denominator, then its integral is log of that denominator. Log of what is denominator? Cosecant x minus cot x plus, this is first part. From this we prove the second part, that is equal to log of cosecant x is taken as 1 by sin x, cot x is taken as cos x by sin x. Log of LCM is sin x, in numerator we get 1 minus cos x plus c. This is log of 1 minus cos x, in half angle it is 2 sin square x by 2. Sin x in half angle it is 2 sin x by 2 cos x by 2 plus c. 2 cancel, sin x cancel one time, we get sin x by 2 by cos x by 2, that is tan x by 2. This is equal to log of tan x by 2 plus c. That is second part. Next result. Integral of f of x whole power n into f dash x dx is equal to f of x whole to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. Let I is equal to, take LHS, integral of f of x whole power n into f dash x dx. Take LHS as I. In this problem we want to find the value of I. If f of x is the given function, f dash x is its derivative. Now let f of x is equal to some t. F of x is taken as some t. Differentiate both sides with respect to x, we get f dash x in LHS. Derivative of f of x is f dash x, RHS, d by dx of t. On cross multiplying, we get f dash x dx is equal to dt. Now, from this I is equal to Now change this function in terms of t, integral of f of x. From our assumption, f of x is t, t power n into f dash x dx, that is dt to dt. Now it is in the form of integral of x power n into dx. The formula of this is x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Here in place of x there is t. From this formula, this value is t power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. But from our assumption, what is t? T is f of x. So it becomes f of x whole to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. See one more example on this. Integral of sin cube x into cos x into dx. See this problem. Here derivative of sin x is cos x. Now it is in the form of f of x whole power n into f dash x dx. Here f of x is sin x, its derivative is cos x. If it is in this form, its value is f of x whole to the power of, that means sin x whole to the power of, n is what? 3. 3 plus 1, 4 by 4 plus c. If f of x is sin x, then its derivative is cos x. Now it is in the form of f of x power n into f dash x dx. From this formula, it is sin x whole power 4 by 4 plus c. Based on these results, we do the problems in the exercise. Now start exercise 7.2. Write the first problem. Integrate the following functions, that means integral of 2x by 1 plus x square dx. Integrate with respect to x. Okay, you see here this problem is in the form of integral f of x by g of x. Now you assume one function to be t, assume one function to be t for which its derivative lies in the given problem. If f of x is equal to, if this 2x is equal to t, what is the derivative of 2x? D by dx of 2x is equal to 2. If you take the denominator 1 plus x square, what is the derivative of 1 plus x square? D by dx of 1 plus x square, derivative of 1 is 0, derivative of x square is 2x. That is in the problem. In this way, you select a function in the given problem for which its derivative is in the given problem. Clearly, derivative of 1 plus x square is 2x, that is in the problem. So we assume 1 plus x square is equal to t. Let I is equal to integral 2x by 1 plus x square into dx. Let it be equation 1. Let 1 plus x square is equal to some t. 1 plus x square is equal to t. Differentiate this both sides with respect to x. What we get? d by dx of 1 plus x square is equal to d by dx of t. Differentiate both sides with respect to x. Derivative of this is 2x. D by dx of 1 is 0. D by dx of x square is 2x is equal to dt by dx. Now on cross multiplying we get 2x into dx is equal to dt. On cross multiplying we get 2x into dx is equal to dt. Or directly take derivative to this, d of 1 plus x square is equal to dt. Taking derivative on both sides, derivative of x square, that is 2x, derivative of 1 0, 2x into dx is equal to dt. You may get 2x dx is equal to dt from this also. If 1 plus x square is equal to t, taking derivative on both sides, derivative of 1 is 0, derivative of x square is 2x into dx, that is equal to derivative of t, that is dt. Okay, you follow any one of these two methods. Now I is equal to, from equation 1, I is equal to integral of 2x into dx, that is equal to dt, by 1 plus x square, 1 plus x square is t. Now the problem becomes integral of 1 by t into dt. We know the formula, integral 1 by x dx log mod x. So integral 1 by t dt log mod t plus c. Once integration is completed, you must write plus c, where c is constant of integration. But from our assumption, what is t? T is 1 plus x square plus c. Therefore, I is equal to log of 1 plus x square plus c. It's very simple. You observe the given problem and you pick up one function whose derivative must be in the given problem. If 1 plus x square is equal to t, then its derivative is 2x, that is there in the problem. So you take 1 plus x square is equal to t. Next, integral of log x by x whole square into dx. You observe that there are two functions here, log x and x. What is the derivative of log x? That is 1 by x, that is there in the problem. So you assume log x is equal to t. First, let the given problem be I. Let I is equal to integral of 1 log x is equal to t. Differentiate both sides. Derivative of log x is equal to derivative of t. Derivative of log x, 1 by x into dx is equal to dt. Now, from equation 1, I is equal to integral of log x is taken as t. So integral of t square 1 by x into dx, 1 by x into dx is dt. Now it is in the form of integral x power n into dx. The formula of this is x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Here n is 2. From that formula it becomes t to the power of 2 plus 1, 3 by 3 plus c. But what is t? T is log x. So log x whole cube by 3 plus c. Initially you must take care which is taken as t. From that you get the integration. Next, integral of 1 by x plus x log x into dx. Let I is equal to let the given problem is considered as I. We want to find the value of I. We write it as 1 by x into 1 plus log x. Take x common from denominator. We get x into 1 plus log x into dx. Now we take 1 plus log x is equal to t. 1 plus log x is equal to t. Then differentiate both sides. Derivative of 1 plus log x is equal to derivative of t. Derivative of any constant 0. Derivative of log x 1 by x into you write dx is equal to dt. From equation 1, I is equal to, you write this in terms of t, 1 by 1 plus log x, that is t, 1 by x into dx, that is dt. 1 by x into dx value is dt. Now it is in the form of integral 1 by x into dx. The formula is log x, log mod x. Here it is log mod t plus c. That is log of, from our assumption, what is t value? 1 plus log x plus c. Next, integral of sin x into sin of cos x into dx. Let I is equal to the given problem. Let it be equation 1. Here let cos x is equal to t. Take this cos x is equal to t. differentiate both sides, derivative of cos x is equal to derivative of t. What is the derivative of cos x? Minus sin x into dx. D of cos x is minus sin x into dx is equal to dt. From equation 1, I is equal to integral of, now sin x into dx, here it is sin x into dx. Sin x into dx is taken as minus dt. Sin x into dx is taken as minus dt. Sin of cos x is taken as t. So the problem becomes integral of sin t into sin x dx is minus dt. This is taken as minus of integral sin t into dt. From the formula, integral sin x dx is minus cos x. So it is minus of minus cos t plus c. In place of x, here it is t. So we get plus cos t plus c. That is cos of, what is t from our assumption, cos x. You must write the answer in terms of x only. T is only our assumption. So finally, you must write in terms of x. Next, integral of sin ax plus b into cos ax plus b into dx. Let I is equal to here the angles are same. It is in the form of sin theta into cos theta. What is the formula of sin 2 theta? Sin 2 theta, 2 sin theta into cos theta. Now from this, sin theta into cos theta, that is taken as 1 by 2 into sin 2 theta. Take this 2 to left hand side, we get sin theta into cos theta is equal to sin 2 theta by 2. So write it as 1 by 2 into sin 2 theta. Here theta is ax plus b to dx. Integral of sin, take this 2 into bracket, 2ax plus 2b to dx. Let 2ax plus 2b is equal to t. 2ax plus 2b is equal to t. Take derivative on both sides. Derivative of x is 1, so 2a into 1 into dx, 2a into 1, 2a into dx. Derivative of any constant is 0 is equal to dt. From equation 1, let it be equation 1, from equation 1, I is equal to 1 by 2 into, you may take this also, this and this are same, 1 by 2 into integral of sin of 2ax plus 2b, that is t, sin t into dx, 2a into dx is equal to dt. From this dx is equal to dt by 2a, right? Dx is equal to dt by 2a. 2 into 2, 4, 1 by 4a into integral sin t dt, that is minus cos t plus c. But what is t from our assumption? 2ax plus 2b. You substitute t value here, we get minus 1 by 4a into cos of 2ax plus 2b plus c. Integral of root ax plus b into dx. Let I is equal to integral root ax plus b into dx. Let ax plus b is equal to some t. Differentiate both sides, then we get a into derivative of x. Derivative of any constant is 0. This is equal to derivative of t. From this, dx is equal to dt by a. Now, you change this in terms of t. Here integration is in terms of x. Change it in terms of t. Let it be equation 1. From equation 1, I is equal to integral of ax plus b is taken as t here. So integral of root t into dx. Dx is dt by a. 1 by a is constant. So it is 1 by a into integral of root t, that is taken as t power 1 by 2 into dt. This is equal to 1 by a into, it is in the form of integral x power n into dx. The formula is x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. So here t to the power of 1 by 2 plus 1 by 1 by 2 plus 1 plus c. 1 by 2 plus 1, that is 3 by 2. 3 by 2. It becomes 2 by 3. So that is equal to 2 by 3a into t. From our assumption, what is t? Ax plus b whole to the power of 3 by 2 plus c.